how I did the Easter eggs. I have already started to do some of these Easter eggs. And the reason I started to do the eggs was that I have been practicing to spin on the small spindles that I have. And I wanted to do something from the attempt of making yarn. And I decided that I wanted to make some Easter eggs. And as you can see here in the branches I have, I already had some knitted eggs. And those were not the ones that I have made. But I wanted to make from my own handspun. And I have made purple. And I have made some green variegated yarn. And I also did, last year, I did my first attempt of spinning was this mohair. And I thought that it would be nice to use them in the eggs. And I also added the colors that I have. This green here and also the purple. So I have made some different kinds of eggs here. And I wanted to show you how I am making the eggs. And I think I will make just a solid color so you can see how I do it. And you cast on, you take a little bit here because you want to leave some for the hanging part. You cast on 3 stitches on the first needle, 3 stitches on the second needle, and 3 stitches on the third needle here. And then you just leave this tail hanging there, and you attach them into a circle. And make sure you're not twisting anything. Just starting on the first needle again here. It's a bit fibbly in the beginning. Knit one round. Just knit stitches. So after knitting one round of the knit stitches, we shall start to do the increasing. And you knit one. And then you knit one in the front and one in the back. So you do the increasing in the second last stitch on each needle, all the time. So you knit the first, and you knit in the front leg and in the back leg. So you increase one stitch there. And then you knit the last stitch. And the way you keep count on what round you're in is to count your stitches on the needle. So now we should have 4 stitches on each needle. Like this. And on the next round, we knit 2 stitches and then we do increase in the second last stitch. So you knit 1, you knit 2, and then you knit in the front leg and in the back leg, and you knit the last stitch on that needle. And you do the same on all 3 needles here. So you end up with 5 stitches on each needle after this round. Knit in the front leg and in the back leg. And the last stitch there. And then we have the third needle. It's a bit fibbly in the beginning before you get something to hold on to. But just be a little bit patient. The first rows here. Yeah, I think it's a nice thing to do something from this first attempt of handspun, so I can have them as a memory. Okay, we knit 3 stitches. 1, 2, 3. And then we knit the 4th stitch in the front and in the back. So we increase 1 stitch. And you knit the last stitch. And by this way of doing it, you get a nice line here on the egg, the little egg. 1, 2, 3, and in the front and in the back, and the last stitch. So we are now round again. One more round. 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches we knit this time, and we do increasing in the 5th stitch and knit the last stitch and the last needle. 1, 2, 3, 4, and you increase in the last one, in the second last one here, and then you knit the last stitch. So now you should have 7 stitches on each needle, so you have 21 stitches. And now we knit 5 rows, and this is where you can put in if you want to make some color work or some other things on the egg. I think this is a good place to put it, where you knit 5 rows. So I will be knitting those 5 rows now. It's to make the little egg shaped as egg. This pattern I am using is a free pattern that I found online on a Swedish magazine who put it out. So it's not my pattern. It's just a free pattern from a Swedish magazine, but I will be writing information down below so you can find the original pattern. It's in Swedish, so you won't have so much use of it, but I just want to mention the source of the pattern. The row legs I found deep in my fiber stash, I found those row legs to create this variegated yarn. And I have been having them in my possession, I think for 6 years or something. And I was so happy to remember them, so I could pick them out and use them in these little eggs. And I was sitting last night knitting these purple eggs, and I started to make these eggs with the purple color work, and I thought that I need some more colors here, and I found these fibers, and I brought out my little spindle so I could spin up some of those fibers to use for this little extra color among the eggs. And we shall see for how long I think that this is funny. This could be Easter presents, I think, for small gifts. You can give away like 5 or 6 eggs or something. That's really, really a nice gift for Easter for someone. Or you can just knit for yourself. That's also nice. I really appreciate to have these kind of things around me. Handmade things. And these are not perfect. I know that these are not perfect. And I am not a perfect spinner. But somehow I think that this is so nice to have something like this. It was my first attempt of spinning on my supported spindle, and to have them in a memory like this in an egg, that's really, really more worth to me than to buy some eggs in the store that are perfect. I think it's a nice little project to knit. You could just have them lying in a bowl on the side of the table, and then when you perhaps you just want to do some other small things in between projects, or you just want your hands to do some other movements, you can pick up and do a little egg like this. That's nice. So we shall see. I think I have done... I think I'm on the last round. And then we shall start to do the decreasing. Yeah. 5 rounds. And now we shall knit 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we knit 2 together. And 1 stitch. So this is what you do now on each needle. Knit 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And knit 2 together. And 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. And knit 2 together. And 1. So you have done this on each needle now. And we knit 1 round without doing any decreasing. Just knit stitches. So you make the egg not round, but shaped a little bit like this, like an egg. So we do 3 stitches. 1, 2, 3. And we knit 2 together. And 1 stitch. 1, 2, 3. And knit 2 together. And 1 stitch. 1, 2, 3. Knit 2 together. And 1 stitch. So that's 1 round. So now we knit 2. And knit 2 together. And knit 1. Knit 2, knit 2 together, knit 1. So now you have 4 stitches on each needle, and it's time to fill your little egg here with something. And I have a lot of fibers, so I'm using fibers. I put white fibers in these eggs, and I had some more purple fibers, so I could fill my purple eggs with purple fiber. Oops. And I'm using the white here to fill up. And I'm just fluffing it up a little bit so I can... It's not getting too compact. And just making a little ball and putting it inside here. You could also use the small ends that I get from knitting this one, cutting off small pieces. You could stop them in the egg as well. So you don't have to use fibers. You could use small scrappy ends of yarns that you have. So we are closing up this little egg now. And knit 1. Knit 2 together. Knit 1. Knit 1. Knit 2 together. Knit 1. So for the last round here, we knit the first 2 stitches together. And knit the last stitch. Knit 2 together. Knit 1. Knit 2 together, knit 1. So now I cut off a quite long piece of the yarn and use the needle for the last finishing bit here. I'm not so afraid of using a little bit too long yarn because I want to have enough to pull it through the egg. So I am taking the needle in these 2 stitches first and taking away that needle. And these 2 stitches on the needle and these two stitches on the needle. And I just pull it through, and I take the needle, just go in the egg and go up in the middle here. And don't pull the yarn too much, because you want the shape to stay like this. And I just make some small stitching here to fill up this hole. And then you just decide on a length that you want for your little tail here, and you cut away. Yeah, so now we have made a little yarny egg. Super nice. And you see the nice lines that they create by doing the increasing and decreasing the way we did. Really, really nice. And I hope that you will get started on this this egg making, so you have enough, both for gifts and for yourself.